biggest challenge has been trying not to be so critical of the things I make, because it doesn't matter if it's perfect. What matters, and this is my entire belief of what Cosco should be, is that it should just be fun. It doesn't have to be perfect. You don't have to look perfect in your cosplay. As long as you are having fun wearing a costume, going out, being with friends, or just making something at home, that's what's important.
Entonces, su desafío más grande ha sido no ser tan crítica con ella misma, porque la idea del cosplay es divertirse, hacer amigos, enseñarle al mundo, no importa que tu cosplay no sea perfecto.
I agree 100%. We are our worst critic, and cosplay is such a personal form of work and also of like your expression that it is hard to, you know, I guess let your message come through sometimes. But I would say to add to it, I think the challenge is sort of maybe how fast the cosplay scene changes and continues to change. So I think as people working in it, and this is our job, it's sort of every few years you have to think of a new way to, you know, stay and like you just have to change your strategy. But then I always try to stay true to why I love cosplay. So I think that's the challenge, is sort of the uncertainty, ever-changing nature.
Para Yaya Han, ella considera que el reto más grande ha sido lo rápido que cambia la escena del cosplay, cómo tienen que cambiar estrategias constantemente para mantenerse relevante, para mantener su cambio, y eso.
Un aplauso. La tercera pregunta que tengo para ustedes es que ustedes mismos, ellas mismas crean sus propios trajes, sus armas, y me gustaría saber cuáles son esas piezas o piezas que más les cuesta crear a la hora de iniciar su proyecto.
So as people who make your own cosplays and props from scratch, what is the hardest part of crafting that? Which, is it the prop or is it the costume?
I think we have different answers.
Okay, so I will make armor any day. I will make a prop any day. If you ask me to sew, it will take me 2 weeks to make something very simple and very basic, because I have always struggled with sewing. For me, it's one of the hardest things. So whenever people make very intricate sewing costumes, it blows my mind.
Okay, para Kimpatsu, lo más difícil, ella puede hacer armaduras en cualquier momento, ella puede hacer armas en cualquier momento, pero cuando la ponen a coser, ella se complica más, porque ella le puede llevar mucho más tiempo coser algo básico que una persona que hace eso de otra manera diferente. Y cada vez que alguien hace un patrón bastante intricado para de tejido, ella le parece impresionante.
The opposite, 100% opposite from Kimpatsu, whereas I love sewing. I've always loved sewing. I think it's so clean. I love fabrics. I design fabrics in America. I design sewing patterns. I love like taking something that is a pile, you know, on the floor and make it something that fits my body. I love sewing.
Entonces ahora Yaya Han es completamente lo contrario. A Yaya Han le encanta tejer, ella tiene su propia línea de telas, su propia línea de patrones de tejido. Entonces para ella lo más difícil es hacer las armas y las armaduras, pero coser trajes, ella le encanta tomar un montón de telas en el piso y convertirlos en algo hermoso.
So what I struggle with is armor and props, because, hear me out, once you've made the piece, it's not done, because then you have to seal it and you have to paint it, so then you're waiting for paint to dry, and also it's so dirty when you have to sand something forever. I'm just like, sewing is so clean, you just get rid of the little fuzzies and you're done. So props to me is like, I'm just always dirty, and I was like, like waiting for the fifth layer of the sealer.
Entonces para ella las armaduras y las armas han sido lo más difícil porque ella lo considera muy sucio porque hay que bregar mucho con lo que es cartón, plástico, telas, pinturas y ella no lo considera eso muy sucio y aparte de eso de que no le gusta tener que estar esperando tanto así como para que la quinta capa de pintura se seque. Y ella considera que es muy sucio, que es más preferible coser, que es más limpio, solamente te deshaces de las telitas que quedan ahí.
But I will add that arguably the hardest thing for me is actually wigs, because wigs are so fuzzy and long wigs get tangled no matter how much you prep them and crimp them or whatever, and it's just always kind of a mess. So.
I agree with that.
Ellas añaden que la parte más difícil para ellas es las pelucas, porque siempre se enredan, siempre vienen muy peludosas, muy llenas de pelusas. Entonces es difícil y son un desastre, no importa lo mucho que uno las prepare.
Bueno, sabemos que tienen muchos cosplays que han hecho a lo largo de su carrera, demasiados, pero yo quiero saber cuál es ese cosplay ustedes recuerdan con cariño y que más las marcó.
Well, since you've been doing cosplay for a very long time, we would like to know, what is the cosplay most beloved to you from all the infinite cosplays that you've done? The one that you loved the most, that you hold a special memory in your heart?
I view my costumes as they're all my children. I love them all. And I think the point of cosplay is the variety. Like, I like being a princess one day and a fighter the next day and a villain on the third day. So I never have a one favorite costume. Usually my favorite is the latest costume I made. So right now it's Adea from Final Fantasy VIII.
Entonces ella dice que ella como cosplayer considera todos sus disfraces como sus bebés y es difícil elegir uno solo en particular, ya que ella lo que le encanta del cosplay es que puede ser una princesa en un día, una peleadora en otro día, un villano en otro día, y es todo muy especial para ella. Entonces, según ella considera, el cosplay, su cosplay favorito es el más reciente que ha hecho, que sería el que ella tiene ahora mismo de un personaje de Final Fantasy.
Okay, so for me, I do have a favorite child.
Y para ella, ella sí tiene un hijo favorito.
My favorite costume that I ever made was my sister of battle from Warhammer 40K. 40,000.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Like, what was the costume?
The sister of battle.
The sister of battle, yeah. Entonces, para ella, su disfraz favorito ha sido el disfraz de las hermanas de batalla de Warhammer 40,000.
So it was a costume. I used to be very good at making things very quickly. I once made 36 costumes in a year.
That's three costumes a month.
It's not healthy.
That's three costumes a month.
So the reason that I like this costume and it's so special to me is because I spent so much time on it, and I think I ended up making, like, it was the same costume, but I made like three versions of it and I upgraded it and I spent time on it for over a year working on the costume, making it better, making improvements, learning new techniques. I traveled with it to so many countries, I competed with it, placed in international events. So to me, it was like this costume that I spent so much time with that it became my baby, but it's also a costume that a lot of people ended up knowing me from. And they always say, oh, I remember you from this costume. So it was like part of my cosplay identity a little bit.
Para ella ese disfraz es particularmente especial porque se pasó más de un año preparándolo, mejorándolo, haciendo más cosas, y ella lo considera como su favorito porque es el disfraz por lo cual ella no solamente trabaja muchísimo tiempo por mejorar y crear y perfeccionar, sino también porque es el disfraz que básicamente la lanzó al estrellato y que todo el mundo dice, ah, yo te recuerdo por este disfraz.
Un fuerte aplauso.
Don't make 36 costumes a year. It's not a good idea. Don't don't make 36 costumes a year. It's not a good idea.
No hagan 36 disfraces al año. No es una buena idea.
Tengo una pregunta y es la siguiente. ¿Cuál es ese consejo clave que le darían a un cosplayer o a alguien que está empezando en el cosplay? Ese consejo que ustedes dicen es el consejo.
Okay, so what is the tip that you would give to someone that is just starting out as a cosplayer? Like the tip. Not a tip, the tip.
You have to let the character guide you. You have to pick a character that you genuinely like. Don't pick something that you think you have to do because it's popular. Don't even pick something because people tell you you look like the character. It has to be a character that you genuinely am obsessed with and want to become, because that passion is going to carry you through learning everything. It's going to motivate you to do what you need to do to learn all the skills and execute all the techniques to be that specific character. And I would say that's my tip.
El consejo de Yaya Han es que elijan un personaje que ustedes genuinamente les encante y no un personaje que ustedes consideren será fácil o les parece a usted. Dejen que el personaje los guíe en vez de ustedes guiar al personaje, porque entre más pasión tienes, más te motivas para hacerlo y más te motivas para hacerlo bien y perfeccionar.
Okay. It's a hard one.
Can you put the microphone a little bit closer?
Can you hear me? So I think the tip I would give anyone starting in cosplay is it's sort of a similar tip to what Yaya has given. You need to be doing cosplay just because you love it. Don't put, especially now, with the way social media is, I think a lot of people feel pressure to make cosplay or to put a cosplay on because, oh, I need to do well on social media, I need to do this, I need to do that. But that doesn't matter. You need to be cosplaying for yourself. So just make sure that whatever you do, whatever you're making, and however you're cosplaying, is that you're just having fun doing it.
Es que el consejo de Kimpatsu es que se diviertan haciendo cosplay, porque con las redes sociales actualmente hay mucha presión como que para hacer cosplay para ellas. Sin embargo, la idea es que hagas cosplay para ti, que te diviertas tú haciendo tu cosplay.